Today, I'm going to walk you through using a new product in the Fiddler family, and that is Fiddler Jam. Fiddler Jam lets us easily troubleshoot remote customer issues, even when that customer is a non-technical user. For this demo, I'm going to use a simple to-do web app. So wearing my end user hat, I'm going to type in buy milk and click submit. And right away, I get an error which notifies me that the item cannot be added. Well, that's no good. After consulting with the support team, they've directed me to use the Fiddler Jam Chrome extension to record network logs while reproducing the issue. Then I can securely send them the logs for further analysis. Let's see how this is done. Now I already have the Chrome extension installed, so I open it by clicking on the icon. The UI is pretty simple, letting non-technical users record and submit issues with a minimal interface. So I can click to start capturing log files, reproduce the issue in my browser, then stop capture to obviously stop capture of the logs. There's also an option to capture screenshots on clicks, so every time I click my mouse, a screenshot will be saved along with the log files. So let's turn that on and start recording. Now that recording is started, I'm going to want to try and reproduce that issue. Let's add buy milk again, and this time it works. Well, it's interesting. Let's try buy bread instead. Now we get the error. Now since that error was recorded, let's stop the capture and share these log files with the support team. Once I click on stop, I'll have the option to view the log details captured. A more technical end user may want to see this. But let's hide those details for now and share the captured sessions. Next, we have this option to set password protection. This will secure and encrypt our log files with the supplied password. So let's enter a password, my email address, and a description to save the logs. Now I can save everything in the cloud and submit the saved logs to the support team. Since I added a password, the logs will be encrypted and everything will be securely saved in cloud storage. And as soon as that upload is complete, a link will be generated and can be manually shared with the support team. Now, switching hats and acting as a support person, I can open the provided URL in my browser, which will take me to the web dashboard. Let's enter the password from the end user here. And once the password is entered, the log file is then decrypted and displayed in the browser. Now the log file contains all the requests and responses that were captured while the end user was replicating that issue. On the left of our view, we see all those request URLs. And on the right, we see the request details and the response details for individual requests. On this one, we can see where a to-do item endpoint failed. I can click on the item to see the details. In the response headers, I'm seeing an internal server error. Well, that likely caused the initial problem. I can also see the screenshot of exactly when that error occurred, giving me even more context and a visual representation of the state of the application at that time. Now I can also add comments to the requests to add additional context for the development team, who will next be looking at the issue. In this case, I'll add a comment on the issue that failed, describing it in some more detail. Now that the support team is done and has triaged the issue, we can then move on to the dev team for further analysis. Again, switching my hats, as the developer team, I can use the web portal to view some details about the request, including the screenshots, just like the support team did. Let's open the failed request again and look at any comments that were added. Now, most importantly, I can then open the captured logs in Fiddler Everywhere to do further analysis, such as replaying the captured session to test the scenario in action. I can also test the behavior of the remote API with the exact parameters used when that request failed. I can also create auto-responding rules to mock the responses and simulate any issues the customer may have experienced. So in the last few minutes, we covered all three user scenarios from the end user's experience of capturing the details of the error through to the support team and how they quickly triaged the issue, finally to the developer and how we viewed the comments and loaded the sessions directly into Fiddler Everywhere to further diagnose and debug. Now, if you're interested in trying Fiddler Jam for yourself, join our early access program at telerik.com/fiddler-jam.